Okay. Check. Okay, so I think this is the first live stream I am doing, so if it doesn't work, bear with me. I am basically trying to get back into oil painting, so I have a ton of oil paints that I had to buy yesterday. I totally forget how expensive they are, but I did the Rembrandt, I think, let me hold it up there, the Rembrandt brand, because that is what I used to use a lot of. Then, because they come in different series, like the more expensive it is, the higher the series, or the higher the series, the more expensive. So I had to go to another brand to get some of these other colors. I think that's these two right there. But that is basically what I'm sort of using today, just to get back into oil paintings. Like, I have to figure out exactly what I was using back in the day, the liquid, turpentine, you know, the all these different tools. These are new brushes that I got. I forgot the brand, Princeton. Okay, Princeton brand. And these are what I've been using with my regular acrylic paints as well as the latex and stuff. But I'm just doing a piece to practice with these oil paints. So I basically had a friend build me a wood panel canvas. So this is like the back of it. Really nice design. And I just primed it, taped off the sides so I don't get any paint on the sides because I like the plain wood look. And then just primed the front of it with spray primer and gesso. So now everything is sort of super, super flat for me to just put on. So that's what we're going to do today. I'm just going to go really easy. Just throwing some paint on, but this is going to be like a monochrome red. And this is going to be more of a sort of salmon-y sort of feel. And then I'm going to sort of just let it dry after that and then figure out exactly what else needs to go in it. Because, you know, if it looks good in the end, I'm going to use this for my sort of piece in an upcoming exhibition at ABV Gallery in Atlanta, Georgia. So that is basically what we're going to do today. But I wanted to make sure I sort of live streamed it as well, just to see exactly, you know, how to start live streaming, because, you know, I want to do that. But I just didn't know exactly how. And then got these vinyl record palettes that I've been making. So definitely go to the website if you want some of those. But yeah, so that's what we're going to do today. And for me, it's been sort of interesting figuring out, like I said, exactly how to get back into oil paints and how to actually use oil paints, because I totally forgot exactly the process, you know, going from light to dark to light. And usually when I'm doing my acrylic paintings, I would always go from dark to light, but I think with oils you have to go from light to dark. That's the process. I'm trying to figure out which brushes I want to sort of get dirty first. So these are the brushes I want to get dirty first. I actually need to make sure I throw in the terpenoid so I can sort of dilute some of these. There we go. So, thing, if you don't know, oils, it uses solvents to sort of dissolve in that water. So I have to have solvent. This is an odorless one. Terpenoid. Hey, Lucia, how's it going? Just finished your book. And very helpful, interesting. That's what's up. Awesome. Glad you got the book. It was definitely difficult to promote it over COVID, mainly because couldn't go out to sort of do the lectures and everything. But a lot of people like you have ordered it online. Why is it so stuck? Oh man, this is really hard to get out. There we go. But super, super glad you got it. Hopefully it was really helpful and you can actually start to figure out exactly how you want your art career to go. So thank you for that, Lucia Hill. You're the best. Okay. So putting down some of this. So I'm going to go from light to dark. I'm going to do the lightest areas first. Okay, we get a lot of that light. A lot of that light. Okay, so now first area would be like the pupil area. And then know exactly how this would go. But I'm really, really liking this oil paint again. Like, remember how smooth they would always be whenever I used it. And then I'm going to actually go back over. I think, I don't know how long it's going to take to dry. Liquid allows for the paints to dry a little bit faster. So that is sort of what I'm going to use. So it's going to dry over the course of a day, maybe 2 days or 3 days. I'm in Denver, Colorado, so it's super, super dry up here. So things do dry a little bit faster, even though it's like not based off of sort of the evaporation. It's just like, I think the oils have to leave the paints or to oxidize or something like that. It's one of those science things. Okay, let's see. Just for this to look okay, I don't know. Connection with the audio isn't very well. Is it part of the phrases? I can't hear. Let's see if I can change up the audio or change up the connection. Try to change up the connection. So hopefully that helped out a little bit. It's not smoother than I thought. Yeah, with oil paint, it's like I have to go a little bit slower, and I feel like I'm painting more like a printer, because with oil paints, it's not like I can layer stuff like I want to. It's more about painting it and changing colors really subtly, at least for my process that I've been doing. Taking one of the colors, this one. This is the nice right there. I can use a larger brush for these areas. Let's see, there's a good plant. There it is. Sweet. This is going really well. Yes, I wanted to do a monochrome piece because I have never really done one of those recently. Whew. That was maybe a slight mistake right there. Terpenoids, sorry, water, so some things get a little bit clumpy. Just been sort of dipping it in there. So, mix things up a little bit.
Let's get my palette knife to sort of start mixing some of these together. Ooh, that's it. I like that. I don't know if this color changed. Let me get my palette knife. Usually, I'm using acrylics. I don't use a lot of my palette knife to do a lot of this pre-mixing because it's usually used to mix with the brush or stamp with the oils. Definitely have to start mixing with the palette knife. It's working a lot better.
Just a little bit darker.
starts getting in there.
Looking good so far. Hey, what's going on? Aranyani? That's what's up. Hopefully the broadcast is still holding up strong. It's not too laggy. Because I am in my studio and I don't have the best connection all the time in my studio. Hopefully you guys are still able to have a good view of what I am sort of just laying down on the canvas right now, because this is like my first time actually using, like I said, oil paints in so long. So I have to get used to the process again. This is definitely different than a lot of my other pieces that I've done in the past. Oh, all creation, what's going on? I'm using this streaming thing called Ecamm. I'm trying to see, okay, the answer back. Let's see, yep. Adding this back. This is my first oil painting in 10 years. Mostly all one solid color. I have to put all this other tones and shit down first.
differently. So if I go with that part in a second, I'll get it lighter. One thing I like about oil paints is like I'm able to paint with like the side corner of the bristles because the paint still is like sort of butter. Unlike oils or unlike acrylic, where you have to sometimes slather it down. Do you miss that about the oil paints? Let me see if I messed it up. There you go. Hey, Monica. Hey, work in practice. That's what's up. Huge fan. Really enjoy your work in practice. That's what's up. Glad you're watching. Hopefully the stream is going well. Because I am in my studio, which is not the best when it comes to streaming. Okay, let me turn it off. Brown again.
what's going on? I'm Lynn. Thank you for joining the feed. I'm just from my first training in about 7 years. Yo, the spike forward is what's going on, brother. Right now I'm just chilling.
is the beginning of the end of the first session. It is the end of the first session. I think we're going okay. Okay, right in the hatchway. Pull this other spot in. Session. Going, let me do that. Okay, so thumbs up. I'll see you guys next time.